In Clinton's head, this building is an idealized, abstract, and perfect thing. From this building site in the woods, he will see it assembled from a rigorously limited palette of materials: steel, porcelain, granite, and glass. It begins with a 60-meter slab of concrete, onto which the steel frame will sit. There's enough space here to fit 7 average-sized homes. A grid of enormous grey porcelain tiles that run throughout the interior will rigorously control the layout. The rhythmic steel frame will support a wall of glass to the south. The north side gets a cladding of dazzling white porcelain tiles that'll be each 1.5 meters square. They part to reveal a glass-clad entrance. The layout is thoughtful and ordered and indulgent. A double garage leads to a cluster of rooms: utility, spare bedroom, gym, and games room. From this nest of spaces, you'll be launched into the main act of the house, a colossal living area that mixes dining, cooking, and relaxing with pieces from Clinton's art collection. Beyond this, in the west wing, an opulent spa and sauna and the 4 main bedrooms and bathrooms will be neatly ordered in a row to overlook a 15-meter outdoor pool. Everything will be built from steel and concrete, other than the timber-framed white roof that'll oversail the building for shade. To produce this design for such an exacting, obsessive client will take a lot of pain and cost a lot, because it is vast.
It's going to look unlike a house, isn't it? In as much as I think the scale of this, the length of it, the sleekness of it is going to resemble more closely a museum or a public building.